बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वी आर हियर एट द रेजिडेंस ऑफ प्रोमिनेंट अफगान पॉलिटिशियन एंड व्हाई आई डोंट से फीमेल पॉलिटिशियन बिकॉज आई डोंट बिलीव इन दैट जेंडर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। अ पॉलिटिशियन इज़ ऑलवेज अ पॉलिटिशियन, वी डोंट हैव टू टैग देम विद ही एंड शी। सो हियर आई एम विद मिस फौजिया कूफी, ऑनरेबल सीनियर पॉलिटिशियन ऑफ अफगानिस्तान, एंड शी इज़ ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द नेगोसिएशन टीम फॉर पीस प्रोसेस फ्राम अफगानिस्तान। शी इज़ रिप्रेजेंटिंग all of us in that very gigantic movement, and let's see what happens there. But right now we are here to talk about what's going on between Pakistan and Afghanistan, but with a primarily focus on the focused future of youth, women, children, and all other sects of life in Afghanistan that need connectivity with the other counterparts in Pakistan. So we'll be talking to her. It will be a short and brief message from her. We want to listen to her, that what is on her mind. So let's ask her what she has to share with us. Ma'am, a very warm welcome to the forum of Pakistan Afghanistan Youth Forum, and I'll be seeking a message from you, that what exactly you have on your mind towards building a strong relationship between Pakistan and Afghanistan.
Thank you so much. Thank you for coming over, and I'm glad that you had a good stay in Afghanistan without any security or any other challenge, and I'm glad that you actually went around the city and you
we were very happy.
The situation firsthand. We are a country in war, but everywhere is not as deteriorating as it's portrayed on the media. So I believe that I believe in people to people relationship. I have been member of parliament, now very close to the people for 15 years. Our political parties actually focused on empowerment of women and youth, so very close to the people, and I believe in people to people relationship. It is sustainable, it can change the narrative. I think in the relationship between Afghanistan and Pakistan, we need to redefine our relationship based on the interest of the two countries. The interest of the two countries in a secure, stable Afghanistan, Pakistan.
No doubt.
I think both countries should work towards that at the community level, at the people's level. Whatever is going wrong at the political level, the people has to fix it through their narrative, through
very true
bringing a new definition of the relationship. So I believe in that, and I believe that there is a new generation inside Afghanistan that keep questioning our relationship with Pakistan. They want to have a healthier relationship, and they think that our Pakistani friends also should revisit their strategy towards Afghanistan. Those traditional power breakers probably are not as impactful and influential as they should be. So therefore it's time for us to agree on a new relationship, which is based on the mutual interest, not only political interest, but also economic and social interest.
Very true.
Both Afghanistan and Pakistan has enormous economic potentials that we can use for the interest of our nation. So let's use that. Let's go beyond the geography of war. Let's bring a geography of peace. Because at the end of the day, the problems of women, the problems of men, the problems of youth, the problems of children from both countries are the same. It's actually the woman who suffer the most.
Exactly.
Be it in the poverty, be it in the war, be it in any instability. So let's work towards a society as women, especially, but also, as you rightly said, as citizens and politicians. Let's work towards an improved relationship. There is no interest in war, actually.
Thank you very much. And another very important thing that comes to my mind, and I will definitely take advantage of your presence here, regarding women, a lot of things are being done. But there is a rumor that if we are not taking steps, we are not taking measures, timely measures, with the shift of regime that is being foreseen right now. Most of them are rumors as well. Most of them are just fear stories, assumptions, fear stories that are being infiltrated in Pakistan as well. That yes, Kabul is going to be banged again, it's being bashed again by Taliban or by whatever fraction. What are the views of masses? Specifically, I'm asking the mind of youth and women, because right now, in last couple of decades, you guys have been working a lot to uplift them. And if war comes back, it means that things are going back to square one. So what is your view about that? What is the view of masses in Afghanistan, You are their representative. You can rightly tell us about that.
Well, people have concerns. Women, above all, have concerns, valid concerns. The concerns come from the time that they were actually witnessing civil war followed by Taliban government, which oppressed women. They oppressed women to stay home and look at the beauties of the world from the small windows of their houses. But I must say that in the past 20 years, Afghanistan has transformed. This has been my issue with Taliban, that I have been telling them to accept the transformed Afghanistan. And that transformation is not only limited to the cities, it is also happening in the villages. If you travel to the villages of Afghanistan, even if there is war, yes, there is, people are losing life, not only military, but also civilians. But if you ask a mother what future she wants for her daughter, probably she will not wear the same clothes that I do. She will not speak the same language the same way I can. But she wants her daughter to have a future. And I think this new transformed form part of Afghanistan would resist any backwarding. They want to see an Afghanistan which is in peace with itself and in peace with the region and in peace with our neighbors and in peace with the world. That being said, of course, when the situation becomes so military and military strategy is preferred by both sides of the war, there is very little room for women or youth. What we are doing in the peace negotiation is we're trying to avoid that military strategy so that there is room for everybody to be part
all
of
inclusive.
Political, inclusive to be part of a political settlement.
Right. Very rightly said. And in the last, as I said, it would be brief and short. I won't tire you with all the interview type questions. In the end, what do you expect from Pakistan-Afghanistan Youth Forum? Because I am here in a very independent capacity and I want to listen to what you have to say about that such forums from Pakistan and Afghanistan with obviously your guidance and I would term it as your guidance and as your supervision as well. I would definitely like a strong woman who can supervise the Afghan chapter from Afghanistan for us. What do you think? What we should exactly focus on?
Well, I think, as I indicated before, people-to-people relationship is long-lasting, sustainable, and will never change with the change of governments. I think the youth forum, Afghan-Pakistan Youth Forum, can create a new narrative in the relationship of the two countries. They can monitor the wrongdoings of their politicians. If there is something wrong that could already create a negative scenario, they can monitor, watch it, and then of course raise voice. They can have exchange programs because it's important to be on the same page. It's important to listen to a Pakistani young boy or girl and see what is her definition of Afghanistan and relationship with Afghanistan. It's also equally important to listen to somebody from Afghanistan, from different region of Afghanistan, and see what they expect from their relationship with Pakistan, with Pakistani youth. What is their impression of the education in Pakistan, for instance? How they foresee their relationship? So people to people, youth to youth, I think Afghanistan and Pakistan both are very young nation. Above 60% of our society
around
are
70.
Youth. The same for Pakistan. So I think the future is on their hand. And today also, they can make an impact. So it's important for them to be engaged. It's important to have a say. And it's important to find a common ground to work with each other.
True. Thank you so much for your time. This was Ms. Fauzia Kufi, a very prominent leader. Political leader from Afghanistan, and as I said, we'll be definitely seeking her guidance in whatever we do at our forum, Pakistan Afghanistan Youth Forum. So right now, signing off from Kabul with Ms. Fauzia Kufi, we'll be coming back again with another prominent member, either from Parliament or any walk of life from Afghanistan. Till then, thank you so much. Stay tuned.